a verse of the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says loud and clear, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Whoever turns away from our reminder, whoever is not bothered about our command, our instruction, we give them a life that is very, very narrow. A life that is full of depression. A life that is filled with sadness. A life that is filled with anxiety and stress. That's what Allah says. So the first effect of turning away from the command of Allah or not fulfilling the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, engaging in the prohibitions. Remember, there are two things. To disobey Allah, one of two ways. Either you don't do what He has asked you to do, number one. Or you do what He told you not to do. Two ways. A person who stays away from prayer, for example, a person who does not give his zakah, a person who does not dress appropriately, those are sins for not having done what Allah instructed you to do. Then a person who commits adultery, a person who gambles, a person who eats interest, and so many other sins where Allah told you don't do this, and then one does it, that is the other type of sin. So Allah says, whoever turns away from us, from our reminder, the reminder includes both of these, we firstly give them a life that is filled with all forms of difficulty and hardship. Now one might say, how do I know that what I'm going through right now is a result of my sin or it's just an ordinary test as a result of elevation of status? There is one main way of telling. When you are a believer who is concerned to obey Allah and to please Allah, you accept whatever comes in your direction with pleasure. That's what happens. You are not depressed about it. If you suffered, your home was taken away from you, you were evicted, you're on the road, you don't have food, you still find on your tongue, Alhamdulillah. Oh Allah, I'm in a much better condition than others. So you are not depressed about it to the degree that you become a failure in every way, especially mentally. You lose everything and you have such depression that you begin to question Allah. In that case, perhaps it may be the result of something you've done that you were not supposed to do, or something you did not do that you were supposed to do. But Allah says, when we catch you, we will not let go. Allahu Akbar.